Welcome to the world famous Jiggy Jaguar radio program.
Raw and uncut, Jiggy Jag, you know how you do it. You know what I'm saying? Keeping it all the way live.
Broadcasting live from Hutchinson, Kansas.
Well, I'm sitting here with a linguist. I had no idea. I love
I didn't
that.
Know you were an
interpreter, but I didn't know that you were a wordsmith.
Call Jiggy right now. 267 22 Jiggy.
Hey Jiggy, what's happening, man? Reminds me of that David Bowie song. Jiggy played guitar. Jeff, it's a great name, man. Thanks so much for having me on the show.
Presenting.
I'm Mike Massey, and you know, you can catch me on Jiggy Jag TV and see a few of my trick shots there. Thank you very much.
Jiggy Jaguar.
I never knew what freedom was until I saw you lose yours.
Welcome to the world famous Jiggy Jaguar radio program all over the world wide web and on 50 plus stations throughout the U.S. and Canada. AMFM247.com. We're good friends with the Starcom Radio Network as well as the Jiggy Jaguar Radio Network. JiggyJaguar.com is the best place to catch our broadcast. Also tune in Radio Loyalty, iHeartRadio as well. And in this hour, we're going to be talking to my good, close, personal, longtime friend, Mr. IQ Al Erzuli. And last week, we had a great conversation. We're going to start this first segment as we do with kind of a review of last week. IQ, that was a fantastic conversation last week. There's starting to be more and more people around the country that are starting to get it. What did you think of the conversation last week? I believe it was Howard Bloom we were speaking with last week.
Of course, Howard Bloom. I got both of his books already.
See, look at that. People
I don't listen.
Yes.
I don't play games. I don't know how to play games. I like to go to the throat, to the jugular.
Yeah.
When you told me he's going to be on the show, I read his profile on Google. And then I thought, okay, he wrote books about Islam, let me read and find out what he has done. Unfortunately, although he said he would be in touch, he hasn't been in touch. Because I read half of the first book, which is Muhammad Code. Very interesting. He had mistakes in it.
Serious
mistakes. Yeah, but I mean, I could have discussed it with him if he wanted to. But he didn't call, so I'm not going to bother.
Well, he's
very knowledgeable. I mean, there's no question.
That's the one thing about him. He is a very, very, very knowledgeable guy. I am so glad we were able to get him on last week. What are some of the mistakes in the book? If you don't mind covering those, we can discuss those in this
segment. Behind his back, I don't want to do it.
No. What I was thinking was just kind of comparing and contrasting some of the things that.
Certain conclusions, for example, he kept using the word God when it should have been Allah. You never use the word God.
Okay.
Allah is not God, so you don't use God. Muslims use God to deceive non-Muslims. Fine.
Yes.
Okay, I'll accept that.
Yeah.
But for a scholar of Islam, especially who is not a Muslim himself, he should never use the word God. It's Allah. The Quran says Allah, they say God.
Yeah.
So use Allah. Anyway, that's another one.
Okay.
And there were some mistakes in history. Not important. I mean, that must have been
Anyway,
but I would have liked to discuss it with him from the intellectual point of view. Okay, so he hasn't been in touch. I'm surprised, in fact. Still, there you go. But otherwise, we got on extremely well, in fact.
It was a good conversation, and we've gotten a lot of positive feedback from it from the listeners, and I know that they really enjoyed the topic last week. Now, to kind of jump into things this week, in this first segment here, I want to talk with you about this Canadian Parliament shooting that took place earlier today. I saw bits and pieces of this. Do you have a lot of information on this?
Look. Okay, I'll tell you what.
Yes.
Dear listeners, I'm addressing our people, the ones who are listening.
Yes.
It is sickening and outrageous how most of our leaders in our democracies, politicians, media, academia, and clergy, are deliberately misleading and misinforming the public. regarding the Islamic threat within our borders from among those citizens who are Muslims. For example, the mass murderer in Fort Hood, a Muslim officer, was slaughtering, as usual, unarmed fellow officers while shouting the Islamic terror verse of Allahu Akbar. And the Obama administration, with the collusion of the military, called it workplace violence. In spite of the fact that the murderer, Bilal, keeps telling them that what he had done was according to Islamic Sharia. He was butchering unworthy human beings because they are infidels, kuffar, enemies of Islam. The same in the United Kingdom. When two Christian converts to Islam butchered an unarmed civilian also in the name of Allah and Sharia, and the public were told that the murderers were radicalized. Now, it is Canada's turn to refute what has happened in the last 48 hours, whereby one soldier was murdered by a hit-and-run vehicle, and now another soldier killed near Parliament. And there was an attack inside Parliament. The same denial of facts and reality are committed by literally every Western government regarding Islam. Ladies and gentlemen, let me enlighten you. There are no radical or militant or extremist or moderate Muslims. They exist only in the distorted minds of the politically correct or totally stupid beings. Islam is radical, militant, extremist, and intolerant, and hence, so are the followers of Muhammad called Muslims. Has anyone ever read or heard of a radical Nazi? The answer is no. How about extremist or militant or moderate Nazi? Never. Why then is there a different set of rules to Islam when Hitler's Mein Kampf, the Nazi master race creed, is exactly the same as Muhammad's Quran item by item? I challenge any listener to call in to disprove anything I assert, especially the following. Muhammad, his Quran, his Sunnah and Sharia are warmongering, hate-mongering, duplicitous, misogynist, intolerant, racist, disloyal, hypocritical, vile, and is totally ungodly. If there are so-called moderate Muslims, why then have neither Europeans or Americans seen a single demonstration by these peace-loving Muslims since 9/11? Not a single demonstration where they should have shown their anger against the so-called radicals who are accused of hijacking the peaceful religion of Islam. Why were Muslims, on the other hand, demonstrating their anger by the hundreds of thousands regarding a cartoon about Muhammad? Why the double standard? The answer is simple, ladies and gentlemen. There cannot ever be so-called moderate Muslims, because Muhammad's Quran and Sunnah forbid it. Those who are in disbelief, let me prove it for you again and again and again, and I hope it will stick in your brain sooner or later. I'm quoting from the Quran. Al-Ma'idah, chapter 5, verse 51. It goes like this. O ye who believe, Muslims, take, not the Jews, Yahud in Arabic, and the Christians, Nasara in Arabic, for your friends and protectors. They are but friends and protectors to each other. And he amongst you Muslims that turns to them for friendship, the Jews and Christians, is of them. Ladies and gentlemen, the implications of the last sentence is of immense importance. And I repeat it, and he amongst you Muslims that turns to them, Jews and Christians, for friendship is of them, means, and only means one thing, that any followers of Muhammad who befriend or under the rule of Christians or Jews or any other non-Muslim group would be considered apostates to Islam, outsiders to Islam, enemies of Islam, who must be slaughtered. in a nutshell. No Muslim can ever be loyal to the American Constitution because it's not from Allah and Sharia. Nor can any of them be loyal citizens because non-Muslim Americans are called infidus, kuffar, unbelievers, kafirun. Before I continue further demolishing the Quran as a divinely revealed book, back to you, James. Tell me what you think.
Well, but this is the thing that I've always tried to figure out when they... I know we beat this topic to death in your segment, but I just always find it so strange that there's all these people in the news media who go, well, we're trying to find Muslims who don't agree with all these radicals. And they always call them radicals. And there's never any Muslims that step forward that go, you know, I don't agree with these people. They never step forward. And the media never covers that part of it.
Because media is colluding either out of stupidity or whatever the intentions of the people who control the media are. But whatever they are, they're traitors to America. Look, take a man like Hannity. Millions of people watch him.
Yep, yep.
The other one, very famous guy, also on Fox.
O'Reilly. Bill O'Reilly.
O'Reilly.
Yes.
And Megyn Kelly
as well.
Megyn Kelly. All of them speak about radical Muslims. But there are no radical Muslims, ladies and gentlemen. They don't exist, only in the imagination of these people. Erdogan, the Prime Minister and President of Turkey, was in a meeting with the European leaders, and he said to them, what are you talking about when you speak about moderate Muslims, radical Muslims, this and the Muslims? Islam is Islam. There are no shades in Islam. You are either a Muslim, and then you are a jihadi, or you're not a Muslim. Why? Jihad is the sixth pillar of Islam. Sixth. But in fact, it's the most important pillar of Islam. They never mention it to you because they want humanity to believe that jihad is a spiritual struggle. Ladies and gentlemen, if you find an American, especially not a Muslim American, telling you that jihad is a spiritual struggle, slap you on the face. He's lying. Either he's lying or he's stupid. Either way, slap you on the face. You've got to wake up. Muhammad said, it's in the Quran, in the Hadith. He said, I wish that I would fight in the name of Allah, jihad, and get killed, martyred, to be resurrected, to fight again, get killed, martyred, to be resurrected, to do it again. Will you tell me? What does that mean? He's talking about death and destruction. He's not talking about spiritual struggle.
Yeah.
And he said that the greatest gift to humanity is when a Muslim dies in jihad. That's it. And the European leaders and our academicians and the media tell the Muslims that they are wrong. They don't know what the hell they're reading. Can you believe that? It's like a Muslim telling the Pope, you don't know what the hell you're talking about.
Yes.
I swear, you're
correct.
Yes. A Muslim is telling the Pope, you don't know what the hell you're talking about. And the Pope is telling the Muslim, you don't know what you have. This is a joke. It's a joke on us.
It is just insane, my friend. It is just insane for whatever reason.
Absolutely, it is insane. It is, you know, it's like the people of the asylum are running the asylum. The people of the asylum, they're not, you know, they are the sick ones, they are the crazy ones, and they're running the show. That's our leaders. What do you think? Obama is telling the truth? The answer is no. The military is telling the truth? No, they're not telling us the truth. Why? They don't know how to handle Islam. And yet to handle Islam is so easy, it's unbelievable. It is easy. It is unbelievably simple. You cannot destroy Islam with bullets because you have to kill every Muslim.
Yeah.
I don't think anybody has got the intention of doing it. Although, the Muslims have every intention of killing us. 100% guaranteed.
Oh, very much so, yes.
Thank you. So it's a one-sided affair. We treat them with respect and let them live. They have no respect for us, and they want us dead. And our politicians say, oh, no, no, Islam is peaceful. It means peace. Islam doesn't mean peace.
No, it doesn't.
The root verb of Islam is aslama, which means submission, not peace.
We're going to do this.
There you go.
We're going to take a quick time out here with IQ Arizona. When we come back, we're going to talk a little bit more about this Canadian Parliament shooting that took place earlier today, and just why the news media just